everybody, it's Bruce here with Traveling with Bruce. I got a video here about a couple that was left behind by Celebrity on a dream Alaska vacation. That's a sad story. Thanks for joining me today, by the way. Thank you for subscribing to Traveling with Bruce, giving my videos thumbs ups. Join us on our group cruise. Details are down below in the description. I have a story here about Abdul and Catherine, who decided to go on a celebratory cruise to Alaska to celebrate their wedding and their anniversary. They came to Vancouver, British Columbia, boarded the Celebrity Eclipse cruise ship. The Celebrity Eclipse, beautiful vessel, 5.5 stars of service, a really nice ship, all the amenities you can imagine. You get a balcony room on a ship like this, man, have you got it made. You can get inside rooms, you can get ocean view rooms and suites. The dining facilities are absolutely fantastic. Really top quality service, great food. You can't go wrong. And the couple arrived in Vancouver, getting ready for an Alaska cruise. And all went well. They boarded the ship. They got their cabin. And the ship sailed out of Vancouver. The beautiful part about the ship is that it is climatized perfectly for Alaska cruises. The solarium here is an indoor facility. So you can swim and get into the hot tub and enjoy the loungers in controlled environmental comfort. No problem. On nice days, you can go outside and enjoy the grass that they have on top of the ship. It's one of those ships that have actual real grass on there. Great views from the restaurants. Everything is great. Unfortunately, on day number 4, Catherine did not feel well. She was running a high fever. And she was really unwell. They came down to the medical center. The doctor ran some tests, gave her oxygen, gave her some an IV line and some medication to control her fever. The next morning, the ship arrived in Juneau, Alaska. And the doctor recommended that they go to the Bartlett Medical Center, the hospital in Juneau, to run some tests in the emergency room just to see what's going on. The couple arrived here, they checked in into the hospital and ran tests, and by the afternoon, early afternoon, Catherine was feeling a lot better, and they decided that they would head back to their ship and continue their cruise. So the couple worked their way down to downtown Juneau, where the facilities are. They got to their ship, and they were denied boarding. The cruise line had decided, the doctor had decided, that Catherine was unfit to continue traveling, and that they would have to leave the ship here in Juneau. And without warning, they were immediately, in effect, homeless. They had nowhere to stay, nowhere to go, and the ship left port without them. They worked their way to the airport here in Juneau, and they managed to put together 4 connecting flights to get back to Toronto, Ontario, where they're from here in Canada. And $3,000 later, they made it back home. But that wasn't the end of the story. As the ship continued its journey, the bills started to arrive. And the couple was charged medical expenses on board the cruise ship, $3,787. The hospital in Juneau, Bartlett Medical Center, $5,797 for the emergency room visit. And the $3,000 airfare, we're talking very close to $14,000 that these two were on the hook for, and they did not have medical or travel insurance to cover it. And this is the lesson learned here. You cannot go on a cruise, no matter where it is, without being protected. And the couple thought that their Canadian insurance, their health insurance from Canada, would cover them because they boarded the ship in Vancouver and was coming back to Vancouver. But no, you're in international waters on an international carrier. The cruise line is not Canadian, and they were not covered. And it's a lesson learned. I don't know what their remedies are. It has made the media here in Canada, the story, but unfortunately, the cruise line is only offering them a partial refund on the cruise for the days that they missed. And that is a small pittance compared to what they're really out of pocket on here. And so for the rest of us, we have to keep this in mind. If you're going to travel on a cruise, 1 week, 4 days, 2 weeks, whatever, make sure you have medical and travel insurance to guard against anything like this happening to you. Thanks for joining me today. I wish it was a happier ending, but it's not at this point. We'll stay on top of the story. If we hear anything more, we'll let you know. Thanks for joining me today. Take care, everybody. Bye for now.